I feet. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this championship matchup of the fourth annual postseason NISC. This year's tournament featured 12 NCAA Division I teams making the trip to Fort Collins, all looking to end the 2022 season strong and build momentum for the 2023 campaign. The championship matchup features the Baylor Bears versus the UNLV Rebels. Let's meet today's teams, beginning with the starting lineup for the Baylor Bears. Leading off in center field, number 21, Mackenzie Wilson. Left fielder, number 2, Taylor Strait. Second baseman, number 4, Emily Hott. Shortstop, number 7, Casey West. Catcher number 44, Josie Bauer. Right fielder number 22, Anna Watson. Pitching today, number 41, Aaliyah Binford. Third baseman number 15, Sydney Collazos. Number 99, Zadie Lavelli. And first base number 12, Kendall Cross. Now the starting lineup for the UNLV Rebels. Leading off at second base, number 20, April Visser. Center fielder number 2, Sophia Morales. First baseman number 15, Mia Trejo. The designated player number 30, Denise Sarmenteris. Right fielder number 4, Janissa Martin. Left fielder number 1, Maddie Schmidt. Shortstop number 24, Samantha Diaz. Third baseman number 50, Lauren Barker. And catcher number 17, Haley Schmaltz. Pitching today for the Rebels, number 48, Alana Beatty. At this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor our country with the playing of the national anthem.
Welcome in, folks. We are here in Fort Collins, Colorado at TC Colorado Field for the championship game of this National Invitational Softball Championship. This game will feature the visiting team, the Baylor Bears, and the home UNLV Rebels. It is winner take all time. Taking a look at the starting lineup now for Baylor. Leading things off, their center fielder, number 21, Mackenzie Wilson. Batting second, left fielder number 2, Taylor Strain. In the three holes, their second baseman number 4, Emily Hott. Batting cleanup, shortstop, number 7, Casey West. Batting 5th, their catcher, number 44, Josie Bauer. Batting 6th, right fielder, number 22, Anna Watson. In the 7 hole, their pitcher today, number 41, Aaliyah Benford. Batting 8th, their third baseman, number 15, Sydney Koyazos. And their designated player today in the 9 hole, number 99, Zadie LaValle. Their starting first baseman today, number 12, first baseman, Kendall Cross. And there is the flex today for the Bears. Starting pitcher today for the UNLV Rebels, number 48, Alana Thede. Thede comes into this game with a 4.73 ERA. This will be her 16th start on the year. 84 innings pitched. Her batting average against is 280. Mackenzie Wilson now set to lead things off here. Takes the first pitch on the outside part of the plate. Called a strike, 0-1. Here's the 0-1 from Thede. And that one misses outside. 1-0 the count. 1-1 the count. And that one catches the outside part of the plate. 1-2 now. Take a look at the defensive alignment for the Rebels. Their battery today, Alana Thede, doing the pitching. Their catcher, Haley Schmaltz. At first, Mia Trejo. Second, April Visser. Third, Lauren Barker. And at short to round out their infield, Samantha Diaz. That pitch is grounded right back up the middle, and that'll be in there for a leadoff single off of the bat of Mackenzie Wilson. Bears looking to get on the board early here in the top half of the first inning. That'll bring up now Taylor Strain. Taking a look at the replay. Wilson gets a pitch low in the zone and just pokes it right past the pitcher, Thede. That pitch misses just on the outside part of the plate. 1-0 the count. Looking at the rest of the defense now for the Rebels. Their outfield, Maddie Schmidt in left field. She made a great play out there in the seventh inning in their game yesterday. Sophia Morales in center, she robbed 2 home runs in their 2 games yesterday. And Janissa Martin out there in right, as that one is grounded to the second baseman, Visser, who just flips it over to Trejo at first for the out. Advancing to second on that was Wilson. That'll bring up now Emily Hott. That one misses the lower part of the plate. That one's grounded back up the middle, getting the green light as Wilson. Here's the throw from the center fielder, Morales, not in there in time. 1-0 now the score on the RBI single up the middle off the bat of Emily Hott. Bears jump out to the early lead in this one. Taking a look at the replay, Hott gets a pitch to hit, does exactly what Wilson does, just pokes it right back up the middle past Alana Thede. That'll bring up now Casey West for the Bears. That pitch catches the outside part of the strike of the plate. 0-1 the count. And that one misses inside. Counts even at 1-1. For Thede, this will be her third appearance on the tournament. Saw her in relief in their first game against North Alabama. Went five innings. The final five innings allowed just three runs. Allowed five runs, three of them earned. As that pitch was in there for a called strike. In her second inning, her second outing, we saw her go an inning and a third, allowing two runs. Looking to try and shut down or limit this Baylor Bears offense. And that one's grounded back up the middle. Unable to make the play is the diving shortstop, Samantha Diaz. Runners now on first and second with one out here in the top of the first. Taking a look at the replay. That's three singles now that have just been poked right back up the middle past Thied. These batters for the Bears doing a good job of putting the ball right back where it came from. That'll bring up now Josie Bauer, designated player for the Bears. Was listed as the starting catcher. They swapped her and LaValle, though, at the start of the game. Squared to bunt, pull it back, and taking off for third. Thrown out, though, by the catcher, Haley Schmaltz. A perfect throw and a good job by Samantha Diaz, the shortstop covering third base. Having a conversation now with the third base umpire is Coach Moore. Our umpiring crew today, Chad Giffreau at home, Bobby Martinez at first, and Dallas Athlebacker at third. That took perfect execution from this UNLV defense. Advancing to second was West. Runner on second now with two outs here to Bauer. As that ball misses high and away. And that ball misses the outside part of the strike zone. 3-1 is now the count here to Bauer, who's batting .281 on the year coming into this game. And that one's hit up the middle. Getting the green light is West. Here's the throw from Morales. Not in there in time as West comes across to score now. 2-0 in the top half of the first. The Baylor Bears lead this one. Getting their offense going early. Looking at the replay. Again, right back up the middle off of the bat of Josie Bauer. As we are now going to see a mound visit from head coach Christy Fox for the Rebels. She wants to go out there, calm down Thied. For UNLV, in their semifinal game yesterday, they had a combined no-hitter. Jasmine Martin going the first six innings and then coming in to get the save, Jenny Bressler. A fantastic performance from Martin and then Bressler getting the save in their game against Central Arkansas yesterday. That'll bring up now Anna Watson. Takes that pitch, just missed the outside part of the plate. 1-0 the count. And that one's grounded back to the second baseman, Visser, who's able to just get it in her glove. Snow cone that one. Two runs come across off the bat of Hott and Bauer. When we come back for the bottom of the first, it'll be Visser, Morales, and Trejo for the Rebels. And that is a good look of the 14er out there in left field here at this TC Colorado field. Leading things off for the bottom half of the first inning will be April Visser. Let's take a look at the rest of their starting lineup. Batting second, their center fielder, Sophia Morales. And the three-hole first baseman, Mia Trejo. Batting cleanup, designated player, Denise Armendariz. Batting fifth, right fielder, Janisa Martin. Batting sixth, left fielder, Maddie Schmidt. Batting seventh, shortstop, Samantha Diaz. In the eight hole, their third baseman, Lauren Barker. And rounding out the lineup for the Rebels, their catcher, Haley Schmaltz. Again, their starting pitcher, who we just saw, Alana Theed. Out there in the circle now for Baylor, Aaliyah Binford. Binford on the year comes in with a 3.39 ERA. This will be her 18th start on the season. 130 innings pitched. Batting average against sits at just 200. Good strikeout to walk ratio from her. 147 strikeouts to just 39 walks. One and one the count here to Visser. Good off-speed pitch swung through by Visser. The NICS is brought to you by Triple Crown Sports, celebrating its 40th year as a creator of memory pack tournaments in multiple sports from the youth ranks through college. See what's going on and what's next at triplecrownsports.com. 1-2 is the count here to Visser. And that one called a strike on the outside part of the plate. One batter faced one strikeout here for Aaliyah Binford, getting started early. Binford will certainly be looking for a quick inning here, get her team back up to the bat, try to get some more runs on the board here early. Try to just take all of the momentum in this one. For the Rebels, obviously looking to try and get some back here. That's Sophia Morales now batting. Great day defensively for her yesterday. Comes in with a 3.88 batting average. That pitch in there for a called strike on the outside part of the plate. For Binford, she came in relief in their semifinal game yesterday, pitched the final four innings, allowing just two hits, no runs, no walks, and struck out four batters. Really kept her team in it, gave them a chance to walk it off in the bottom half of the seventh as that pitch is grounded to the shortstop West, able to make the play, firing it over to Cross. Two outs now. That walk-off hit for the Bears came courtesy of Josie Bauer. Looking at the replay. West able to field that one cleanly going to her left. That'll bring up now Mia Trejo for the Rebels. Baylor entered the bottom half of their seventh inning yesterday, trailing by a score of 3-4. Off-speed pitch, misses the top part of the strike zone. 1-1 now is the count here to Trejo. That pitch got the outside part of the plate for a called strike. 1-2 the count. UNLV had to play two games yesterday, one to get to the semis, and that one, Jenny Bressler went the complete seven innings, allowed just three hits and one run against North Alabama. A fantastic performance from her. Then got the close in their second game. As that pitch bounces across the plate, 2-2 is now the count here to Trejo. That one misses outside. yesterday in the semifinal game for UNLV against Central Arkansas. The Rebels held on to win that one by a final score of just 1-0. That won a home run off of the bat of Denise Armendariz. That was in the fourth inning for them. Good off-speed pitch from Binford. Just caught Trail looking on that. Second strikeout of the inning. Three up, three down inning for her. When we come back, bottom of the lineup for the Bears, Binford, Collazos, and LaValle. Two to nothing is the score here as we get set for the top half of the second inning. Aaliyah Binford will lead things off for the Bears. Had a great first inning, striking out two batters, both of those strikeouts looking. Tends to get a lot of those strikeouts looking, especially with her off-speed pitches. Just locking up opposing batters. Off-speed pitch there from Thede, swung through by Binford, who's batting .321 on the year. That pitch misses the outside part of the plate. Counts even at 1-1 here to Binford. That pitch fouled off into the netting down the first baseline. 1-2 now the count here to Binford. For Thede, she's looking to have a turnaround inning here after allowing two runs in the top half of the first. Wants to have a quick inning and get her team back up to the plate. 1-2 is the count here to Binford. That one misses outside, evens the count. 2-2. And that one grounded to the shortstop, Samantha Diaz. Able to fire it over to Trejo at first, just in time to get Binford for the first out of the top half of the second. That'll bring up now Sydney Collazos. Looking at the replay here on this one. Binford reaching way out to get a piece of that one. Slow grounder, but able to make the play was Diaz. Now to Collazos. That pitch misses low in the zone. 1-0 is the count. Here's the 1-0 from Thede. Off-speed pitch just misses. Maybe a little bit low and away on that one. 2-0 now the count here to Collazos. He's batting .277 on the year. That pitch fouled off by Collazos. Counts now at 2-1. Right, 2-1 is the count here from Thede. And that one misses outside. 3-1 now. On deck right now for Baylor, Zadie LaValle. Swinging through that one is Koyazos on the outside part of the plate. Full count now, 3-2. Big pitch here from Thede. Here's the payoff pitch. That one was high in the zone, fouled off though, out of play by Koyazos. Count's still full. 3-2. And again, the payoff pitch from Thede. That is hit into right field by Sidney Koyazos. A one-out single to get things started here for the Bears. That'll bring up now Zadie LaValle. Looking at the replay. Koyazos gets a pitch on the outside part of the zone. Able to take it opposite field. In there in front of Martin to right. I do believe we're going to get a pinch runner here for the Bears. And we are coming in place of Sidney Koyazos, number 6, Rachel Hurton. Excuse me, number 6, Grace Powell. Coach Moore electing to get a little bit more speed on the bases here with Powell as that ball gets away from Schmaltz, allowing Powell to advance to second. Want to know the count here to LaValle. And that one in there for a called strike. Counts even, 1-1. One out with a runner on second. And that one just misses the outside part of the plate. 2-1 now to LaValle. And that pitch misses the outside part of the plate. 3-1. Top of the lineup on deck for the Bears. That being Mackenzie Wilson. That pitch fouled off by LaValle. Counts now full at 3-2. Back-to-back full counts here from Thede. Payoff pitch. That one's grounded to the shortstop, and I think we're going to see runner interference here. And they are both going to be called out. Having a conversation here between the umpires. So what it looks like is going to happen is I believe they're going to call Grace Powell out for the interference. Safely in at first, though, is LaValle. So that will bring up Mackenzie Wilson now. Two outs in the top half of the second inning. Runner on first. That pitch in there for a called strike. That pitch misses outside. And that one grounded to the first baseman, Trejo, who all she has to do is step on the base for the third out of the inning. Good bounce back inning there from Thied. When we're back for the bottom of the second, it'll be 4-5-6, Armendariz, Martin, and Schmidt for the Rebels. We're back here at TC Colorado Field, and there's a good look at the crowd here. Got a good attendance out here for this championship game. A beautiful Thursday late morning. Why not come out and enjoy some softball? It's about 73 degrees out here in Fort Collins right now. Few clouds out there. And batting now, Denise Armendariz provided most of the offense for UNLV in this tournament. Of the last 10 runs that have scored over the last three games for the Rebels, she is responsible for 9 of those. 9 out of the last 10 RBIs. As a coach, that's something you love to see but also hate to see. Love that Armendariz is doing as good as she is, but also would love to get the rest of your offense going. And that pitch misses on the inside part of the plate. Count is now 2-1 here to Armendariz. And that one popped up on the left side of the field. Settling under this one, the shortstop, Casey West, making the play out there in foul territory. One out here in the bottom of the second. The Sports Bra, sports bar and restaurant, woman owned and operated. Great food, delicious drinks, and an upbeat space that supports, empowers, and promotes girls and women as they impact sports in their community. Check out the sportsbrapdx.com for details. That'll bring up Janisa Martin now. As that pitch misses on the outside part of the plate. This one grounded to the third baseman, Koyazos. Foul territory, though. I would like to send my apologies to the pitcher for UNLV. It is Alana Thede. Been mispronouncing that one. We'll be sure to get that rest for the rest of get that right for the rest of the way here today. Alana Thede. 1-1 the count here to Martin. Good off-speed pitch there by Benford. Gets Martin to swing through that one. 1-2 is the count now. And that one called a strike. Third strikeout, all three of them looking so far today for Benford. That'll bring up now the left fielder, Maddie Schmidt.
Left fielder number one, Maddie Schmidt.
That pitch called a strike on the outside part of the plate. Infield coming in a little bit with Schmidt up to bat. Oh, one. Fouls that one off. 0-2 now is the count. Two outs here in the bottom of the second. And that one fouled off towards her teammate on deck, Samantha Diaz. Count still sits at 0-2 here to Schmidt. And that one just misses the inside part of the plate. Count's now 1-2. One and two. Ground ball to the first baseman, Cross. Fields that one, steps on first, but it was just foul before Cross was able to field it. Getting another chance is Schmidt as the count stays at 1-2. Benford has her signed, shakes that one off from LaValle. Now here's the 1-2 delivery. And that one fouled off again by Schmidt, doing a good job battling at this one. Count still here at 1-2. As Benford gets ready for the delivery to Schmidt. Off-speed pitch just misses high in the zone. Benford thought she had that one. Not the case, though, says the home plate umpire, Chad Jeffro. Count's now even at 2-2. Two's all the way across the scoreboard. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Two runs for Baylor as we are now in the bottom half of this second inning. And that one grounded to the shortstop, West. Throws it over to first. A bad throw, though, as that one was in the dirt. Unable to make the scoop is Kendall Cross at first. Taking a look at the replay now.
Shortstop number 24, Samantha Diaz.
Should not have been an overly hard play for West. Had time as it was hit right to her. The ball just gets away from her. And just barely missing the scoop on that one was cross. That'll bring up now Samantha Diaz. Fouls that one off. Let's take a look at the defensive alignment now for Baylor. Their battery today, Aaliyah Benford doing the pitching, Zadie LaValle at catcher. First, Kendall Cross. Second, Emily Hott. Third, Sydney Koyazos. And at short, Casey West. Their outfield today, Taylor Strain in left, Mackenzie Wilson in center, and Anna Watson, their right fielder. Good Osby pitch in there for a called strike. 0-2 now here to Diaz. Diaz looking to keep her team alive here in the bottom of the second. Fourth strikeout of the day for Aaliyah Benford in just two innings. When we come back for the top half of the third, it'll be Strain, Hot, and West for the Bears. Two to nothing is the score here as we get set for the top half of this third inning at TC Colorado Field. We have a change now on the mound, in the circle for the Rebels, now pitching Jasmine Martin. Went six innings of shutout softball. No hitting Central Arkansas yesterday. Threw six. As that pitch is squaring around to bunt was Taylor Strain. Fouls that one off, though. That pitch just missed the outside part of the zone. Counts now at 1-1. Final line for Alana Thede. Went two innings, gave up five hits, two runs, did not walk or strike out any batters. And that one squared around and missed by Taylor Strain. 1-2 is now the count. That one fouled off by Strain. Count will stay at 1-2. And that one swung through by Strain. Martin striking out the first batter that she sees in this one. Good pitch from her. That'll bring up now Emily Hott. Number four, Emily Hott. And that pitch grounded to the first baseman, Trejo, for the second out of the inning now. College sports evaluation is on the cutting edge of sports analytics. Founded in 2020 by the owner of Triple Crown Sports, Dave King, CSC provides youth and collegiate athletes with verified sensor data. Trusted by and tested with over 200 college programs, CSC's team of dedicated mathematicians provide the only valid data outlet available to accurately evaluate players as they compare to the two collegiate levels. Visit CSEval.com to learn more and get your athlete involved. Owen won the count here to Casey West. Lines that one into right field, and that one gets down past the diving right fielder, Janisa Martin. That'll be extra bases as in safely for a stand-up triple is Casey West with two outs. Chance to extend their lead now. Great effort by Martin laying out here in right field as we take a look at this hit. And Martin comes up just short of that one. Great job, though, backing her up was the second baseman, April Visser. Love to see that, her chasing that one out there. Ends up in right field, always somewhere to be on the softball field. Josie Bauer now in the box. Great block by Haley Schmaltz. As that pitch was in the dirt off of the bat. Or in the dirt from Martin. Two of the count here to Bauer. Bauer gets a hold of this one, rips it foul though. Out of play down the right field line. 2-1 is the count. Here's the 2-1. Taking that one for a strike is Bauer. And that one misses outside. Full count now here to Bauer. Warming up in the bullpen now for UNLV, number 28, Sabrina Jolin. Also saw Jenny Bressler out there a little bit earlier, not currently warming up. Off-speed pitch in there for a called strike on Bauer. Second strikeout of the day for Martin, and she comes in and shuts down the Bears. No runs come across. When we come back for the bottom of the third, it'll be Barker, Schmaltz, and Visser for the Rebels. Lauren Barker is getting set to lead things off here for the bottom half of the third inning. Still looking to get them on the board. Currently trailing in this one, 2-0. That pitch in there for a called strike from Binford. Binford gets the sign, and that one misses outside. Counts it 1-1 here to Barker. Barker batting .240 on the year coming into this game. Off-speed pitch hit to deep left field. Chasing after this one is Lauren Strain, able to make the play at the wall. A loud out there in deep left field off of the bat of Lauren Barker. That'll bring up now Haley Schmaltz.
Catcher number 17, Haley Schmaltz.
Schmaltz comes in with a .438 batting average on the year. As that one misses outside. One and oh is the count here to Schmaltz. And this one grounded to the shortstop West. Fires it over to first and in there in time. Making that a close play with Schmaltz, just unable to get there in front of the throw. Take a look at the replay now. Trying to cut that one off was Koyazos, unable to do so as it got through to West. And getting it there just in time. Top of the lineup now for the Rebels, April Visser. Is that pitch? Swung through by Visser. 0-1. That pitch in there as well. 0-2 now the count here to Visser. Visser, a .363 batting average, fouls this one off. Behind home. Count is still 0-2 here to her. That pitch just missed the top part of the strike zone. 1-2 is now the count here to Visser. Visser leading her team right now in home runs with 15, second in RBIs at 48. Binford shakes off that sign from LaValle. That one just misses the inside part of the plate. 2-2. Off-speed pitch popped up on the left side of the field. Coming in is Strain. Able to settle under that one for the third out of the inning. 3-up, 3-down inning from Binford. Top of the fourth, we'll have Watson, Binford, and Koyazos for the Bears. Welcome back, folks. We are here at TC Colorado Field in Fort Collins, Colorado. Joining me now, head coach for the UNLV Rebels, Christy Fox. Coach, what do you guys need to do right now to get the bats going against Aaliyah Benford?
Yeah, I think we're just guessing, and she's doing a good job of mixing speeds. We just really got to stay on the ground and work the middle of the field, whether it's the hard stuff or the slow stuff. And I think that we're just too worried about the fastball getting by us, and I don't think we need to be.
Gotcha. And then made the switch to Jasmine Martin. What do you expect to see out of her the rest of the way here?
Yeah, she's going to mix her speeds, hit her spots. I think this is a great opportunity for us to give our entire pitching staff a championship game experience and see what they're capable of. Of course, we want to come out here and win the game and compete our best, but we also want to use this as an experience and get these players in some difficult positions so that we're ready next year when we are playing in a conference tournament.
Coach, thanks for joining me. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you. Go Rebels.
One and zero is the count here to Watson. In there for a called strike, 1-1. That pitch in there for a called strike as well. 1-2 now. Watson comes in with a .291 batting average on the season. Fouling that one off behind home plate. Martin has her sign. Here's the 1-2. Fouled off again by Watson. Count will stay at 1-2. Triple Crown Fast Pitch is home base for a remarkable set of youth softball tournaments from coast to coast that push teams to be their competitive best. College coaches come to recruit as well. Grow your game by suiting up at the next TC Fast Pitch event. 1-2 still the count here to Watson. A good off-speed pitch there for Martin. Watson able to foul that one off, though. Watson way out in front of it, just able to hold the bat up long enough to get a piece. Watson getting a hold of this one, sends it into right, settling under it, though, the right fielder, Martin. That'll bring in now pitcher for the Bears, Aaliyah Benford.
Number 41, Aaliyah Benford.
Off-speed pitch, that one sent into left center field. Chasing this one is Morales, and it's going to be extra bases here for Benford. She's in there safely with a stand-up double to get the Bears going here in the top half of the fourth with one out. And that'll bring up now Sydney Collazos.
Third baseman number 15, Sydney Collazos.
Collazos singled to right field in her last at bat. Pops this one up on the right side. Tagging right now is Benford. Not going to go. Took a couple of steps, then retreated back to second. Good job by Martin getting that ball back in quickly. That'll bring up now Zadie LaValle for the Bears.
Catcher, number 99, Zadie LaValle.
It'll take a two-out hit now to score Benford. That one in there for a called strike. 0-2 now the count here to LaValle. Be sure to stick with us as at the start of the bottom half of this fourth inning, we'll have an interview with head coach for Baylor, Glenn Moore. That one fouled off out of play down the left field line. 0-2 still the count here on LaValle. Oh, 2. That one in the dirt. Good block by Haley Schmaltz. Forces Binford to stay out there at second. Counts at 1-2 here to LaValle. A 183 batting average on the season. Fouls that one off into the netting down the third base line. Count will stay at 1-2. Good job battling here by LaValle. Here's the 1-2 for Martin. That one misses the outside part of the plate. 2-2 is now the count. Martin gets the signs from her coaches. Here's the 2-2 delivery. Good off-speed pitch. Just misses the bottom part of the strike zone. 3-2. Good eye there from LaValle. Able to hold off of that one. That one looked like it just floated on in there. Three and two. Payoff pitch from Martin. LaValle takes that one as it misses the outside part of the plate. Great at bat there from LaValle. Got down 0-2 early, battled back, able to take the walk on that. Top of the lineup now for the Bears, Mackenzie Wilson. Runners on first and second now for the Bears. Takes that pitch high in the zone. 1-0. And that one's low, bounces across the plate. 2-0 now here to Wilson. Comes into this game batting a ridiculous 430 on the season. And that is the outright team lead. Almost 100 points better than anyone else on the team. And that one misses low and away. 3-0 now here to Wilson. Going out to have a chat with her pitcher, the catcher, Haley Schmaltz. And 0 here to Wilson. We'll see if she's taken here or if she has the green light to swing away. And that pitch missed the outside part of the plate. A four-pitch walk there to Wilson. Bases are now loaded as that will bring up Taylor Strain. 0-2 on the day. Looking to get her first hit.
Left fielder number 2, Taylor Strain.
Strain, 325 her average on the year. off-speed pitch misses low in the zone. That is now seven straight balls from Martin. And that one called a strike on the outside part of the plate. Counts now even again at 1-1. And up in the bullpen again, Jenny Bressler out there for UNLV. 1-1. Off-speed pitch grounded to the shortstop, Diaz, who will just flip it over to Visser. Bears load the bases, unable to bring any runs across. When we come back for the bottom of the fourth, it'll be Morales, Trejo, and Armin Derez, as well as an interview from Baylor head coach Glenn Moore.
No runs, one hit, no errors, and three left off.
Welcome back, folks. Joining me now, head coach for Baylor, Coach Benford, doing a great job out there in the circle right now. What do you expect to see from her the rest of this game?
Yeah, we just got to keep some big hitters off balance. That's the key. And, you know, they're going to barrel one up every now and then. We need to get some more runs on the board. I'd feel more comfortable.
Yeah, absolutely. You got those two runs in the first inning. You've had a lot of action on the base paths, just unable to bring any more across. What do you guys need to do?
Yeah, the same thing. They're keeping us off balance right now and not able to put a couple of hits together to score a run. So we just got to execute some better at-bats and try to time our change up. We're doing a good job of laying off the low stuff and working her deep in the count. I think that'll pay off eventually.
Coach, thanks for your time. Good luck the rest of the way. That was Coach Moore. We thank him for joining us here. Leading things off now in the bottom half of this fourth inning will be Sophia Morales. Scoring to bunt. Gets a piece of it, fouls that one off though. Grounds this one right back to the pitcher, Benford, who just fires it over to cross at first. One out in the bottom half of the fourth.
First baseman number 15, Mia Trejo.
That'll bring up now Mia Trejo. That one misses outside. And that one misses the outside part of the strike zone. Two and zero is the count here to Trejo. Off-speed pitch in there for a called strike. Another off-speed pitch just misses the top part of the plate. Count will move now to 3-1. Trejo swings through that one. Good pitch there from Binford. Full count now at 3-2. Another off-speed pitch. Fifth strikeout now on the day for Aaliyah Binford, having herself a fantastic performance. That'll bring up the DP for UNLV, Denise Armendariz. Looking to get her team some action going here. Ground ball just fell. Missed third base by about a foot. Owen won the count. That pitch misses low and inside. Counts even at 1-1. That one lined into right field, going to get foul though. One and two is the count. And out in front of that one is Armendariz. Six strikeouts now on the game for Aaliyah Binford, having herself a day out there in the mound. Hot Weston Bauer when we come back. Jenny Bressler now out there in the circle for UNLV. Final line as of right now for Jasmine Martin. Went two innings, allowed just two hits, no runs, walked two batters, and struck out two as well. Not super surprised to see this move from head coach Christy Fox. As she mentioned in her interviews, obviously wants to win the game, but trying to get a lot of her players this championship experience. Bringing in now the senior pitcher, Jenny Bressler. Arguably one of the best pitchers in the Mountain West Conference this year, as Emily Hott gets set to lead things off for Baylor. For Bressler on the year, a 1.62 ERA. This will be her 49th appearance on the year. 220 innings pitched. A 1.92 batting average against. As that pitch misses outside. 2-0 now. That one fouled off of the catcher, Smaltz. 2-1. Hot 1-for-2 on the day. And that one misses low. 3-1 now the count here on Hot. Three and one, the count to Hot. And that one just misses the outside part of the zone. Leadoff walk by Emily Hot. That'll bring up now shortstop, Casey West.
Shortstop number 7, Casey West.
West grounds is just past the outstretched arms of Lord and Barker at third. Runners on first and second. And that'll bring up Josie Bauer.
The designated player, number 44, Josie Bauer.
Bauer with an RBI in the first inning on her single to center field. That first inning featured 4 singles from the Bears, all of them right back up the middle. That pitch low and away, 1-0 the count. Bauer had the walk-off single for Baylor yesterday in their game against Kansas, allowing them to advance to this championship game. Laying down a bunt. That one just goes foul, though. Fielded by Barker.
Yeah, boys! Yeah, boys! Here we go, boys! Here we go, boys! Cincinnati, go!
1-1. And attempting to bunt again was Bauer, unable to get a piece of that one, though. Count's now 1-2 on her. Likely see her swinging away with 2 strikes. And that she is, and that one is hit into left center field, and that is going to roll to the wall. Scoring easily is West. Getting the green light now is Emily Hott. Here's the throw and gets there just in time. Now advancing to third is Bauer. She is going to be thrown out, though, trying to advance. Good throw by the catcher, Schmaltz. 2 runs, though, come across on the RBI double off of the bat of Josie Bauer. And the Bears now lead this thing by a score of 4-0.
Right fielder number 22, Anna Watson.
That'll bring up now Anna Watson. Looking at the replay, Bauer hits this one into left center field. Schmidt got to it quickly. There was a play at the plate. This would have needed a little bit of a better throw from their shortstop, Diaz, as Watson swings through that one. Oh, and one is the count here to Watson. 1-1 now. That one fouled off, going to get out of play into the third base dugout of UNLV. Counts now at 1-2. And that pitch misses above the glove of Haley Schmaltz. That'll even the count at 2-2 here to Watson. And that one swung through by Watson. First strikeout of the day by Bressler. That pitch fouled off into the netting. 1-1 is the count here to Binford. That one swung through by Binford. 1-2 now the count. That pitch outside, 2-2 now. That one popped up and gonna get out of play behind home. Count will stay at 2-2. That one called a strike on the outside part of the plate. Second strikeout now for Bressler. Two runs come across off of the RBI double. Two RBI double from Josie Bauer. Welcome back, folks. We are here at TC Colorado Field as we get set for the top half of this fifth inning of play. Make your way to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and see how real Southern hospitality works to make your business trip or family vacation a perfect stay. The beaches are forever inviting, and with entertainment options at every turn, you know the good times will fill every minute of the day. Get the full picture of Myrtle Beach at discoversouthcarolina.com. Janisa Martin will be leading things off for the Rebels. Off-speed pitch in there for a called strike. Here we go. And that pitch called a strike on the outside part of the plate. Aaliyah Binford now with 7 strikeouts on the day as she got Martin looking.
Left fielder number 1, Maddie Schmidt.
3 strikeouts in a row now for Binford as well, as that will bring up Maddie Schmidt. Two and oh is the count now here to Schmidt. And that one grounded foul down the third base line. That one misses inside. 3-1 is now the count. This one grounded to the third baseman, Koyazos. Fires it over to Cross. 2 outs now in the bottom of the fifth. That'll bring up now Samantha Diaz.
Shortstop number 24, Samantha Diaz. Here we go, babe. That's
it. Diaz struck out in her last at bat. That one's grounded foul down the third base line. Counts even at 1-1 here to Diaz.
Here we go, babe. Here we go.
That one's lined at the first base dugout, foul. That one misses inside. Counter's now 2-2 here on Diaz. Shaking off that one is Binford. Now has her pitch. And that one's lined at the first base dugout. Count will stay at 2-2. That pitch misses high and away. Count is at 3-2. Payoff pitch from Benford. And hitting that one into right field, the first hit of the day for UNLV. Fielding that one is Watson. Aaliyah Benford went 4 2/3 of no-hit baseball until that one right there from Diaz. A great performance from Benford. That one is grounded to the shortstop West, fires it over to first. One hit in that inning for the Rebels, nothing going though. When we come back for the Bears, it'll be Collazos, LaValle, and Wilson.
No runs on, one hit, no errors, and one left on.
Sydney Collazos set to lead things off in the top half of this sixth inning, looking to extend the lead here for Baylor. As that pitch gets past Schmaltz. For Aaliyah Benford, just saw her no-hitter get broken up after 4 2/3 innings. She also took a perfect game earlier in this tournament through 4 1/3 inning against UCSD. That was their first game of the tournament. Great stuff so far from Aaliyah Benford. For the Rebels, now that they've gotten that one hit across, just need to keep this one close. They're only trailing by 4. As that one is grounded to the second baseman, Visser, able to flip it over to Trejo at first. One out in the top of the sixth. That'll bring up now Zadie LaValle. As there's a good replay of that.
Number 99, Zadie LaValle.
Visser able to make the routine play. LaValle 0 for 1 in the day. She walked in her last at bat, her last plate appearance. Also reached on a fielder's choice back in the second. That pitch misses outside. 1-0 the count. And that pitch misses low, 2-0. And that one swung through by LaValle. 2-1 is the count. That one misses on the outside part of the plate. 3-1. Yeah. That one's fouled off by LaValle. Count's now full at 3-2. And that pitch fouled off by LaValle, staying alive 3-2. Payoff pitch from Bressler. And again, fouled off by LaValle. The Puerto Vallarta College Challenge welcomes a deep roster of standout Power 5 and mid-major college softball teams over two sessions starting the NCAA season in style at one of Mexico's top tourist spots. Fan packages available. Learn more at pvcollegechallenge.com. Bressler getting the signs right now from her coaches. And here is the payoff pitch. And that one misses the outside part of the plate, allowing LaValle to walk and reach safely. Top of the lineup now for the Bears, Mackenzie Wilson. We are going to see a pinch runner here for LaValle. Coming in now, number 5, Ashlyn Walkendorf.
Attention, please, now running at first base, number 5, Ashlyn Watkendorf. Now batting number 21,
Mackenzie Wilson. And that one is lined into left. Able to make the play, though, is Schmidt. Two outs now in the top of the sixth.
Left fielder number 2, Taylor Strain.
That'll bring up now Taylor Strain, 0 for 3 on the day. Here we go, 1 and 0 the count here to Strain. That one called a strike on the outside part of the plate. One and one. That one swung through by Strain. 1-2 now. One, two from Bressler. Strain fouls that one off. Unable to make the play off of the netting. Head coach for the Bears, Coach Moore. That pitch outside, two's across the scoreboard now. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Baylor currently leads this one by a score of 4-0 here in the top half of the sixth. 2 innings left for UNLV to get some runs going. That one's grounded to the shortstop, Diaz, and makes the play, firing it over to second. A great play by Diaz. Knew she wouldn't have had a chance at first with the speed of Strain. Able to get the out at second, though. When we come back for the top bottom half of the sixth, it'll be 9-1-2, Schmaltz, Visser, Morales. Haley Schmaltz will lead things off in the bottom half of this sixth inning, looking to get some run support going here for UNLV. Aaliyah Binford still out there in the circle for the Bears. Only allowed one hit through the first five innings. That one coming last inning off of the bat of Samantha Diaz. Is that pitch in there for a called strike? And that one called a strike on the outside part of the plate. 0-2 now to Schmaltz. Off-speed pitch, misses outside. One, two. Swinging through that one is Schmaltz. Eight strikeouts now for Aaliyah Binford. That pitch called a strike. Oh, and one is the count here to Visser. Off-speed pitch just misses the top part of the zone. Evens the count at 1-1. That pitch is ground, fouled off behind home plate, 1-2. And that one low in the zone, evens the count at 2-2. Here's the 2-2. And that one swung through, fouled off, but held on to by Zadie Lavallee. Nine strikeouts now on the day for Aaliyah Binford.
Center fielder number two, Sophia Morales.
Well, that'll bring up the center fielder, Sophia Morales. Two groundouts on the day. One to short and one back to the pitcher. And that is a line out to short. Another quick three up, three down inning for Aaliyah Binford. When we come back for the top of the seventh, it'll be 3-4-5, Hot, West, and Bauer for the Bears. It is the top half of the seventh inning here at TC Colorado Field. Leading off for the Bears, number four, Emily Hott. Jenny Bressler looking to keep this a four-run ball game, give her team a better chance in the bottom half of the fourth inning. That pitch misses high. 1-1 is the count here to Hott. 1-for-2 on the day. Singled up the middle in the first inning. Walked as well back in the fifth. As that pitch misses high. 2-1 now. That one fouled off by Hott. That'll even the count now at 2-2. Hott able to get a piece of that one, fouling it off behind home plate. Two and two. And again, fouling that one off is Hott. Staying alive in this count against Bressler. Count still at 2-2 here to Hott. And that one misses inside. It is now a full count here to Emily Hott. Good battle going between these two. It's the ninth pitch of the at-bat. And that one just misses outside. A leadoff walk to Emily Hott. The Colorado 4th of July Youth Fast Pitch event takes over the state in 2022 from Fort Collins to Colorado Springs, with more than 1,000 teams taking part in the largest softball tournament in the world. Festival nights, superior competition, college camps and clinics, dedicated recruiting moments, and much more. Check it out at cosparkfire.com. Casey West now batting and grounds this one foul down the third base line. West having herself a 3-for-3 day in this one, as that one is hit into center field, fielded though by Sophia Morales out there. One out now in the top of the seventh, and that'll bring up the designated player, Josie Bauer.
The designated player, number 44, Josie Bauer.
Bauer with 3 of the 4 RBIs today for Baylor. One in the first and 2 more on her double back in the fifth. Would love to extend this lead even more here for Baylor. That one is fouled off down the third base line. And that pitch misses. And that one fouled off into the street behind us. Counts even at 2-2. And that pitch fouled off by Bauer, staying alive in this one. Count will stay at 2-2. Two pitch from Bressler. And that's grounded to the shortstop. Diaz able to get her glove on it and makes the great play, firing that over to Trejo at first. What a play out there by Samantha Diaz at short. Kept that one from getting into the outfield. Likely would have allowed Hott to advance. Take a look at the replay now. Hott ranging way to her, Diaz ranging way to her right. Able to make the play. Anna Watson now lines this one, grounded to the shortstop Visser, able to flip it over to Trejo at first. No runs come across for Baylor. When we come back for the bottom half of the seventh, it'll be Trejo, Armendariz, and Martin. Rebels need to score at least four to keep this one alive. Bottom of the seventh here at the championship game of the National Invitational Softball Championship. These two teams outlasted the rest of the field. Baylor currently with the 4-0 lead against UNLV. Leading things off for the Rebels will be number 15, Mia Trejo. Off-speed pitch from Binford gets Trejo way out in front. And 9 strikeouts on the day so far for Binford, just 2 short of tying her career high. Another off-speed pitch that's grounded to the pitcher, Binford, able to flip it over to Cross. One out in the bottom of the seventh. That'll bring up now Denise Armendariz. Provided most of the offense for UNLV as of late. Looking to get them started here in the bottom half of this seventh. She lines that one foul down the right field line. Be sure to stick with us after the conclusion of this game, as we will have the have a trophy presentation as well as the all-tournament teams announced, then have an interview from the winning head coach. 0-1. That one's hit into the right side of the field, gets down now in foul territory. Count is at 0-2. And that one is popped up into left field. Settling under this one, Lauren Strain. Excuse me, Taylor Strain. Able to make the grab. Two outs now. That'll now bring up Ariana Martinez. Pinch hitting in place of Janisa Martin. That first pitch misses high and inside. Rebels are down to their final out. Binford gets the sign. Here's the 1-0. Ground ball, and that'll get through on the right side of the infield. Just fielding that is Watson getting it back in. A two-out single from Martinez.
Left fielder number one, Maddie Schmidt.
That'll bring up now Maddie Schmidt. Schmidt swinging first pitch, grounded to the third baseman, Koyazos able to first, and that'll do it. Baylor holds on to win this one 4-0, and they are the champions here at the National Invitational Softball Championship, finishing their season in style. Congratulations to them. Also have to give a big congratulations to UNLV for making it to this championship game here, taking second place in this tournament of 12 teams. I'm going to take a quick look at some of the stats before we get into this trophy presentation. Aaliyah Binford went the complete 7 innings, allowed only 2 hits on the day, striking out 9 batters, just 2 short of her career high. Did not allow any runs, did not strike out any batters. For the Rebels, Alana Thede got things started, went 2 innings, allowed 5 hits, 2 runs. Then we saw Jasmine Martin go the next 2 innings, allowed 2 hits, no runs came across, walking 2 and striking out 2. And then Jenny Bressler pitched the final 3 innings for the Rebels, allowing just 2 hits, 2 runs, walked 3 batters, and struck out 2. Only offense today from the Rebels, a hit from Martinez just there in the bottom of the 7th, coming in to pinch hit, and then one more from Samantha Diaz. Binford held this team to only 2 hits. For the Bears, 3 RBIs off of the bat of Josie Bauer. We saw one more from Emily Hott back in the first inning. We're going to take a quick break here, folks, and we will be back with the trophy presentation here at TC Colorado Field.
security, Denise Sarmenteris.
Welcome back, folks. We are here at TC Colorado Field as the all-tournament team players for UNLV are being announced. Jenny, those three all-tournament team players for UNLV, Jenny Bressler, saw her do a great job in the circle throughout the tournament, as well as Mia Trejo and Denise Armendariz. Both of them having great tournaments as well. And again, congrats to UNLV on taking second place in this tournament. Now going to get the all-tournament team members from Baylor, as they're still working on getting things set up here. And as you may have seen on the monitor there during the quick break we had, was head coach for Baylor, Coach Moore, got a what appeared to be a Gatorade or water bath out there from the rest of his team. That's something I can confidently say, being able to watch this Baylor team throughout this whole tournament. They've just been having a lot of fun out here. And I'm sure when we get Coach Moore for that interview, he will be joined by a good number of the members from his team. Been mimicking him throughout the interview, throughout all of his interviews in this tournament.
And now, the all-tournament team members from the Baylor Bears.
Now we have those all-tournament team members.
Number 7, Casey West.
The first one being Casey West. Done a great job at short. Saw her some at second as well as at pitcher throughout this tournament for the Bears.
Mackenzie Wilson.
No surprise there, seeing the top of the lineup for the Bears, Mackenzie Wilson.
Number 22, Anna Watson.
As well as Anna Watson.
And
Watson had a two home run day earlier in the earlier in this tournament. And now finally named to the all-tournament team and tournament MVP, Aaliyah Binford.
And accepting this year's 2022
and absolutely deserving so, especially after her performance here in the championship game, as they are now awarded with this championship trophy.
Congratulations to both teams. Thank you for joining us in this year's fourth annual Women's NISC.
And again, we want to say congratulations to Baylor winning the championship here at this fourth annual NISC tournament. They are now all being handed their individual trophies as well as their championship t-shirts. We're going to take another quick break here. And when we come back, we will be joined by Coach Moore for an interview.
Mike Wilmer.
Welcome back, folks. We are here at TC Colorado Field. The final score in this championship game, Baylor holding on to win 4-0 over UNLV. Coach, talk to me about your team's performance throughout this tournament. Some technical difficulties right now. Bear with us here for a minute. Working on getting this fixed.
Hello? Got me?
I think we got him.
Yeah. I'm just very proud of this team. They came in here with a lot of energy, excited. They had a goal to win this thing from the start. And, you know, the season didn't come out quite the way we had hoped as far as early on and winning the games that we thought we were capable of winning, a very young team. But couldn't be more proud of the way we grew through these extra games and practices. So I'm very, very proud of these teams. I'm very grateful to Triple Crown, Dave King, everybody that made this event possible.
Absolutely. Coach, Aaliyah Benford went the complete seven-inning shutout, named tournament MVP. Talk to me a little bit about her performance throughout this tournament as well.
Well, amazing is the word that comes to mind. I mean, she's a kid that's going on about half a tank of gas with injuries and just being worn out, of course, but she just reached down and pulled it out. Just very, very proud of her. She's a phenomenal athlete, and it's fun to watch her finish that one out and do it in dominating style.
Absolutely. And Coach, you guys have been having a lot of fun, it looks like, throughout this season, just watching the team behind you. What are you guys looking forward to going into this 2023 season? Have a lot of returning players.
Good question. We are young, and this team motivates me to go to work every day. They are fun to coach. Been coaching a long time, but this team is they light my fire every day to come to work, if you want to call it that. They're very talented, and we've got some good kids coming in as well. It's going to be a lot of competition for playing time, but we're on our way up, and I'm very, very proud of them. Next year looks exciting.
Coach, congrats on the win. I appreciate the time.
Thank you.
I'm going to recreate that picture. That picture, whenever I play.
Oh, okay.
It's empty, I promise.
Okay.
That's
so cute. Okay. I don't know what you're doing.
The final score of this one, 4-0, Baylor holding on to get the win over UNLV. Once again, for the final time, congratulations to both of these teams having success here at the National Invitational Softball Championship. Again, this tournament put on by Dave King, the fourth annual tournament. We will be looking forward to having this tournament once again next year. And that's it for us here at TC Colorado Field in Fort Collins, Colorado. For the entire team, I'm Matt Gator. The Women's NICS is produced by Triple Crown Sports in association with Button Pusher Media.